Get ready with a pen and paper, cause we are going to solve some problems now. Let's begin with easy one. First one. Two charges, Q1 and Q2, separated by some distance r, experience a force F. If the distance is doubled and the charge is halved, the new force is... Here are the options. Let's look at the solution. We know the expression for Coulomb's force, but here's a tip. Since we are comparing forces and dealing with ratios, the Coulomb's constant can be completely ignored. So we will write F equals Q1 Q2 by R squared. Now, since the distance is doubled, R becomes 2R, and the charges are halved, meaning Q1 becomes Q1 by 2, and Q2 becomes Q2 by 2. Thus, new force F dash would be Q1 by 2, Q2 by 2 divided by 2R the whole squared, giving you Q1 Q2 divided by 16 R squared, which is F divided by 16. That's the answer. Alright, you're done. Calculate the ratio of forces between two charges when their separation is half and when it is doubled. You got that? Read it carefully. Your options are this. Pause the video and solve it. Okay, the answer is... Next one. Two charges separated by some distance d in vacuum experience a force F. Now they are put in a medium of dielectric constant K. What's the new distance such that the force remains the same? Solution. The first thing you can think about is that the force is always maximum in vacuum. Thus, the force would decrease in that medium if the distance was unchanged. Therefore, the distance must be reduced to keep the force from decreasing. Makes sense, right? So the new distance must be smaller than the old distance, which immediately eliminates options A and C. Okay, now let's work it out. The force in vacuum would be F equals 1 over d squared. The charges are not going to change, so forget about that. Inside the medium, the new force F dash becomes equal to 1 over k r squared, where r is the new distance. But the two forces are equal. Therefore, 1 over d squared equals 1 over k r squared, making r equals d by root k. Okay, your turn. Now, the force inside the medium is given as F. You have to calculate their distance in vacuum, for which the force becomes 1/4. Pause the video and try to solve it. Okay, I hope you have this answer. Question 3. Two identical metallic spheres have some charge Q and 3Q. They are brought together and separated back to the same distance. We have to calculate the new force. Alright, first of all, why would the force change? The answer is obvious. Conduction. Charges will transfer from one metallic sphere to another when they are brought together. But how much charge gets transferred? Or put another way, what is the final charge on either of the spheres? You may be inclined to think that charge transfer takes place until charges are equalized. However, in general, that is not true. Charge transfer always takes place until the potentials are equalized. Think of two beakers connected together with water in one of them. The water will flow until the heights are equal. The height is equivalent to potential and the water is like charge. However, if the beakers are identical in shape, then when the heights are equal, even the amount of water ends up becoming equal. Our question specifically mentions that the spheres are identical. Thus, they must end up with the same charge. So how do we calculate that charge? Answer is simple, charge conservation. The total charge before and after must be the same. The total charge before being in contact is Q plus 3Q, which is 4Q. After conduction, both spheres get equal charge. Let's call it as X and X. So after conduction, the total charge becomes 2X. Therefore, from charge conservation, 4Q equals 2X, making X equals 2Q. Now all we have to do is calculate the ratio before and after conduction. Before, F equals Q times 3Q, which is equal to 3Q squared. Afterwards, F dash equals 2Q times 2Q, which is 4Q squared. Divide by 3 and multiply by 3 so that this can be called as F, making F dash equals 4 by 3 F. Your turn. The two spheres here carry a charge of plus Q and minus 5Q. After conduction, they are now kept to twice the distance as before. So a fairly similar problem that you should be able to tackle. Here are the options. And the answer is, I hope you understood why the answer is negative, right? Think about the direction of the forces before and after conduction. Okay, moving on, here is a challenge question for you. If you can solve this one, then you have clearly understood the above problems. Ready? Go! Two identical spheres A and B carrying a charge of plus 2q and minus 3q separated by some distance experience force F. This time, a third identical uncharged sphere is first brought in contact with A and then with B, and then it's thrown away. Find the near force between A and B. No options. Try to do this within a minute. Okay, pause. Now, if you got this answer, then you were absolutely right. Congratulations. Okay, let's do a couple of true-false questions. A body can have a charge of plus 3.3 times 10 to the minus 18 coulombs. True or false? Do you know what concept we're talking about? Charge quantization. Any charge Q must be equal to N times E, where N is an integer and E is a charge on the electron, 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19. So in this case, N equals 3.3 times 10 to the minus 18 divided by 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19, which ends up becoming 20 point something something, which is not an integer. Therefore, charge quantization immediately tells you that the answer is false. This charge cannot exist. But what about this one? True or false? If you haven't figured it out already, I'll give you the answer. The answer is true, just by inspection. Why, you ask? Do the calculation again. This time, you would get N equals 20.625 times 10 to the power 2, which is equal to 2065.5. You may first think that, hey, that is not an integer. But since the given numbers only contain a maximum of two significant figures, our answers also cannot do any better than two significant figures. So we are sure only of the first two numbers. Hence, the real answer is N equals 20 dash dash. So it's 2000 something. The blank spaces could be filled with any number. This could well be an integer. So can a body have that charge? Sure, because of the uncertainty in the problem. Therefore, the answer is true. So this was a very conceptual problem. Alright, let's do some serious problems now. We have two charges, Q and 4Q, fixed at origin and A, 0. We need to find out at what coordinate would a third charge, little q, be in equilibrium. Several thoughts should crawl up in your mind. First one being, we don't know what little q is. So, does the answer depend on that? Second, can we make a rough guess as to where would the equilibrium points be? Okay, first of all, the equilibrium point must be on the line joining them, because two vectors can only cancel out provided they are parallel and opposite to each other. That gives us three options, here, here, or somewhere. Let's look over here. Since all charges are positive, it's going to experience a repulsion towards the left due to the charge at A and also due to the charge at B. So the two forces cannot cancel out. The same would happen here as well. The two forces would just add up towards the right. But here somewhere in between, the force due to A would be towards the right and due to B towards the left. Bingo! It's going to be somewhere here in between the two charges where the forces can cancel out because their forces are in the opposite directions. We could further narrow down our guess as to where it would be in this region. Near A or B or at the center. Well, since charge at A is smaller, to cancel out the forces, you need to be closer to it. So remember, equilibrium points will always be closer to the smaller charge. Alright, now let's do the math. Let's say the equilibrium point is somewhere here at a distance x from point A. Let's consider the right direction to be positive. In one dimension, vectors can be just dealt with by positives and negatives. The force due to A on this little cube would be towards the right and positive. So f of A is plus kqq by x squared. The force due to B is towards the left, so it is minus kq into 4q divided by a minus x the whole square. The total force on q is fa plus fb, which must be zero because it is in equilibrium. So equating, we get q into q by x squared equals 4q into q divided by a minus x the whole square. The q's cancel out. This immediately tells you the equilibrium point is independent of little q. That's a relief. Now, take the square root and do the algebra, which ends up giving you two possible answers. X equals a by 3 or x equals minus a. Since we already figured out that the answer must be in between the two charges, the solution we need is x equals a by 3. Thus, the equilibrium coordinate is a by 3, 0. So this was a little bit more involved problem. Alright, now your turn. A similar problem, but instead of 4q, the given charge now is minus 4q. The answer will definitely change. So follow the same chain of thoughts as I did when I solved my problem, and you should get the answer to this without much difficulty. So the answer is minus a comma 0. Alright, one last conceptual problem. A charge Q is placed right in between two similar charges, big Q. We need to find the value of little q such that the system is in equilibrium. Okay, your first thought would probably be that the equilibrium point is independent of little q's, like we saw in the last problem. You are absolutely right, of course. Clearly, the charge little q would be in equilibrium regardless of its value. However, this question wants the entire system to be in equilibrium, which includes the two big q's as well. If you look at this big q, it is experiencing a repulsive force towards the left due to this big q. So to make sure that it stays in equilibrium, this small q must be negative, so that it attracts the big q, balancing the repulsion. Now, since the distance is not mentioned, the answer must be independent of that. So to keep the math simple, let's take this distance as 2, and this becomes 1. Take the right side as positive. Then, f1 plus f2 equals 0, where f1 is minus kqq by 2 squared, and f2 is plus kqq by 1 squared. So minus q squared by 4 plus q into q equals 0. Solving this, we get little q equals q by 4. But remember, used this way, Coulomb's law only takes care of the magnitude of the charges. So the magnitude of the charge is q by 4. But as discussed already, the charge must be negative. Therefore, the final answer is little q equals minus big q divided by 4. Okay, I would like to end this episode with one last question for you. But first, some background. When any system is in equilibrium, it can either be stable or unstable. We would say a system is stable if, when you disturb it, nature drives it back to the equilibrium position. simple example would be this system. The ball is in equilibrium at both points, A and B, because net force is zero in either cases. However, you can feel it in your bones that point A is a very stable equilibrium position, because if you disturb it a little bit, nature tries to drive it back. However, point B is an unstable equilibrium, because if you disturb that, nature doesn't drive it back and the equilibrium is just lost. So for some reason, nature loves position A, a stable equilibrium, and hates position B, which makes it unstable equilibrium. So the final question for you is our system of these three charges in stable equilibrium? Try to figure this out for yourself by giving a small nudge to any of the charges and check if nature tries to drive it back. And then, you can also look up something called as Earnshaw's theorem. So that's all, folks. Thank you for watching this episode, and let me know your waves and thoughts about this. And if you have any interesting questions, queries, put it in the comment section, and I will address it in the next episode. So stay tuned.